NHL, and it consists of Tyler Sander, Jerry Taylor, Caitlin Marsh, Eric Cotton, Austin Linscomb, Todd Henry, Berta Bonstutter, McKenzie Place, Richard Conrad, Claudia Coleman, and Shannon Brown. I'm Caitlin, and I have the history. And in 1910, on November 26th, 1917, the NHL was founded, and the teams included the Montreal Canadiens, the Montreal Wardros, the Ottawa Senators, the Toronto, Quebec Bulldogs, Quebec, I did not add the picture. And on November 26, 1917, the Calder became the first president. December 15th, the NHL's first exhibition games were played. December 19th, Richie scores his first NHL goal. On January 19th, the goalie is allowed to leave feet. On February 18th, Vina Records was the first NHL shootout. On March 2nd, it was lone first league scoring. On March 20th of 1918, Toronto was the first NHL team in the Cup Finals. December 28th, Benza was the first goal to record an assist. On April 1st of 1919, influenza epidemic cancels the Cup Finals. In the 1920s, and on April 4th, 1921, the Ottawa Senators defeated the Vancouver Millionaires 2-1 in the decisive fifth game of the 1921 Stanley Cup Finals. On February 11th, Toronto and Ottawa settled for the first tie. March 2nd, last 7-on-7 pro game. March 22nd, Hewitt broadcast first hockey game. March 31st, King Clancy plays all six positions. February 9th, the neighbor wins first individual award. On October 11th, 1924, Bruins Maroons granted franchises. December 1st, Boston hosts Montreal in the first U.S. game. March 30th, the Victoria last non-NHL Cup winner. March 15th, 1926, New York Rangers granted the franchise. March 2nd was Hinesworth records his 20th shootout. On March 28th was the first final between the two U.S.-based teams. And February 20th of 1930, Benedict first to wear bowling mask. In the 1930s, on September 27th of 1930, the annual NHL governor's meeting, a new rule was passed, and it was the puck must be propelled into the attacking zone before any player of the acting side can enter that zone. Ross first to pull his goalie was in March of 26. Detroit team becomes the Red Wings on October 5th, 1932. The NHL holds first All-Star game on February 14th. The NHL institutes the penalty shot on September 22nd. January 14th, goalie awarded his first point. November 7th was the first coast-to-coast radio broadcast. September 24th, governor agreed on icing rule. March 7th, Boston wins first Prince of Wales trophy. April 16th, finals go to the best of the seven series. March 17th, the teammates finish 1-2-3 in scoring. And February 25th was the first televised hockey game in the U.S. The 40s, on January 3rd, 1943, Chicago's Red Brentley scored a goal with assists from the brothers Max and Doug in a 3-3 Blackhawks tie at New York. Is the first goal in NHL history with 3 points all from the same family. February 5th, Dutton becomes the second NHL president. And September 11th, Hockey Hall of Fame was approved. March 18th, Richard first to score 50 goals. March 30th, Richard nets his first final overtime goal. September 4th, Campbell replaces Dutton's as president. October 13th, Leaf loses his first official All-Star game. June 2nd, 1948, Launch awarded its first Art Ross Trophy. November 3rd, Howe makes first All-Star appearance. April 16th, Leafs win third straight Stanley Cup, and then Ivan sets coach the 50th win in the plateau. In the 50s, the NHL meeting in Montreal, the league announced a rule change to allow for a delayed whistle. When teams ice the puck, a full-strength, henceforth fast skater of the offense team chased down the puck before defending team touched it. In October, the first televised All-Star game, and Danny Golovin calls last game. In May, it was the Red Kelly wins first Norris Trophy. In March, as Zamboni makes its NHL debut and Richard Suspension initiates Montreal Riot. In December 29th, officials wear the vertical stripes. In January, Bellevue appears an SI cover. In June, minor penalty ends after goals. In April 14th, Habs capture fifth consecutive cup. In the 60s, August 26th, it was the original Hockey Hall of Fame building, and it had its official opening on the grounds of the Canadian National Exposition in Toronto. Originally opened only during the 3 weeks in the summer when the CNE was on, and the hall gradually began to open the weekends and then became a year-round tourist attraction. On November 10th, Hall's game streak ends. In June 5th, NHL's first amateur draft. November 8th, Gardeners installs separate sin bins. March 22nd, goalie Johnson plays every minute. January 27th, Ulf Sterner first Swede in the NHL. March 12th, Hall first to score 50-plus goals. And in September, Bobby Orr signs with Bruins. January 18th, All-Star game played mid-season. May 2nd, 1967, last original Six Cup final. June 5th, NHL expands with six new franchises. March 2nd, Espeto's first to score 100 points. March 29th, Espeto records 15th shutout. April 5th, Orr first defenseman to win Ross. May 22nd, Buffalo Vancouver join the NHL. In the 70s, the NHL history was made as two brothers faced each other in goal for the first time. It was Ken Dryden's, and Canadians beat Dave Dryden's 5-2 at the Montreal Forum. Dave played parts of 9 seasons in the NHL with the Rangers, Blackhawks, Sabres, Oilers, while younger brother Ken ended up in the Hall of Fame. November 9th, Atlanta Islanders joined the NHL. Clark reaches 100-point plateau. Expansion Flyers the Stanley Cup. KC and Washington receive franchises. Jarvis plays in the first game. Sitter sets record with 10-point game. Habs win record 60 games. Bossy becomes the first rookie to score 50 goals. Barnes and North Stars merge. 4 WHA teams join the NHL. Goalie Smith credited with a goal. Gretzky, youngest 100-point scorer, and Gordy, Marty, and Mark skate together. In the 80s, the Atlanta Flames franchise moved to Calgary, Alberta. The Flames joined the league before the 1972-73 season. Gretzky's greatest season, the Colorado moves to New Jersey. The Shedder 5, Gretzky extends streak to 51 games. Penguins pick Super Mario. Gretzky's fastest 1,000 points. Bowman, the NHL's winningest coach. In March, it was American Broughton, his hit century mark. Coffey breaks Ord's record. Hotman was the first D to 1,000 points. Jarvis plays record last game. Hextall shoots and scores. Gretzky has heart, and Gretzky crowned in LA. In the 90s, the NHL was approved to the sale of the Minnesota North Stars by George and Gordon Grund in exchange for their being granted the rights to Bay Area team that would begin play in October 1991. Thus, the San Jose Sharks were born. Hall followers, father with heart. Lindros traded with the Rangers and Flyers. Lightning and Senators joined the NHL. Bettman named first commissioner. North Stars moved to the Dallas. Gritz's passes Howe with number 802. American Molin tallies 1,000th point. Jagger leads the NHL in scoring. Nords and Jets lead home. Gartner nets number 700. Whalers become Carolina Hurricanes. The helmetless McTravis retires. The NHL expands to 30th teams by 2000. The Gretzky scores the 1,000th career goal, and Gretzky plays in his final game in April 18th, 1999. Up next would be Eric Cotton and Shannon Brown with the demographics.
Okay, here's a chart of the nationality of the demographics of players in the NHL. In 1917 through 18, Canada was 90% of the NHL players in playing currently. Second came Czechoslovakia with 90% as well. And the United States came in 1939 and 40, They had a currently high record of 80% players in the NHL.
These are the demographic stats of 2014-2015. And Canada is still in the lead with about 53.2% of all the players in the NHL originate from there. USA is second with 23.6%. And the rest are from other countries around the world, with Sweden, Czechoslovakia, Finland, Russia, Slovakia, and Germany.
Here's a breakdown. Looking back at over 90 years of the NHL's history, the league has evolved from having almost exclusively Canadian players based on highly diverse leagues with players' nationalities ranging from Canada to Japan. After the 70s, the Canadian dominance gradually diminished as players from the United States, Sweden, Finland began to find their ways into the NHL in greater numbers. By the end of the 80s, the share of the Canadians in the league have dropped approximately 75%, and hovers now around the 50% mark. Percentages of American players have risen considerably during the last decade. At the beginning of the millennium, the share of players from the United States was 50%. 10 years later, it has increased to almost 25%.
This is the breakdown by position of the players. The forwards, there's over half of them that are Canadian.
Here's the breakdown of defense. Once again, half of the defensemen in the NHL are Canadian, with a quarter of the United States, and then half, 1%, maybe 2% are from other countries around the world.
The goalies, it's around the same. The Canadians are still about half of the makeup of the NHL, but the United States is the next largest, and the rest of the other countries.
Cup finals with especially weak performers among minority viewers. African Americans made up between 1% and 5% of the audience for each game. Hispanics made up between 2% and 6%, and Asians viewers made up between 3% and 4%. Overall, the demographics made up just 6 through 13% of the audience for each game, making the Stanley Cup finals easily the least diverse sporting event examined.
There's not a lot of women that have been in the NHL. Actually, there's only one. Her name is Manon Rayon, and she was the first and only woman to play hockey at the NHL level. This was in 1992, and there is no Women's National Hockey League. William Reid was the first black player to skate in the NHL. This was in 1935, and after that, they started the William Reid All-Star Game to celebrate diversity. As of September 2014, there are about 30 black NHL players in the NHL. Thank you. Here's the highlight clip.
You're ready. Next, we have some NHL stats with Jerry Taylor and Todd.
In the beginning of the NHL, there were less average goals. There were more average goals in the very beginning because there were less players on the ice, less teams, and less equipment, so they got hurt more often, and there was a lot more room on the ice to move around. We're not at many offenses and no defenses. It's just everybody was selfish, and now everything is leveled off, but in the 80s, offenses exploded and goalies were really small. They didn't have the equipment yet, now they do. And one example of a great player in the 80s was Wayne Gretzky. He scored a lot of goals, and now there's better defenses, new equipment. Now there's more assists in early years of the NHL. They only gave out one assist per goal. And they were less likely to pass. If they did pass, it had to be backwards. And now they can pass the puck whoever, whenever, but they can't go offsides, which is when the player crosses the line before the puck. And now you can be awarded up to 3 assists per goal.
All right, the hits this past current year, there was 12,619 total hits. The leading team was the LA Kings with 31 hits a game. And if you date back to about 2000-2001, there were 57,425 total hits, with the New York Rangers leading with 32 a game. The NHL, like the NFL, is making a lot of rules for player safety, which is why the further you go back, the more hits a game there will be. Austin Lipscomb with the teams with the most Stanley Cups.
First is the Montreal Canadiens, who have won the most with 26 times, and their last win was in 1993. Number two is the Toronto Maple Leafs with 13 Cup victories. The last win occurred in 1967. The number three is the hometown Detroit Red Wings, who won 11 times, and the last win was in 2008. Number four is the Boston Bruins, who won 6 times and most recently in 2011. And to round up top five is the Edmonton Oilers, who won 5 times and the last win was in 1990. And with youth hockey, it is Tyler Sagan.
Alright, so the NHL has put really high importance on youth leagues and development at the very young level because they want to get kids started young because hockey is a very skillful sport to learn. Youth leagues organized around the 1960s is when they started being most prevalent. They started kind of growing throughout the 70s and 80s. At least this is in the US. They had youth leagues in Canada in about the 1950s. Around there. NHL has a program called Hockeys for Everyone, which is their youth development program, which their main goal is to get kids of all ages, people of all races to get in, start playing hockey, get them excited about hockey, try to increase the demographics a little bit. The American development model is something started in 2009 by the NHL. It's kind of like a charity organization. They accept donations for people to start youth leagues, you know, get new equipment for leagues that aren't as developed, that don't have that much funding. Some recent rule changes within youth hockey. Can't check until age 14, I believe it is. And they have to wear the full cage face mask when they play hockey too. All these points about youth hockey connect to the social theories. Internationalist theory goes back to learning from your environment, and the youth hockey leagues try to develop a safe and fun educational environment so kids can learn hockey and pursue their dream of making it to the NHL. And it also connects with conflict theory. This has to do with the role of women playing hockey as well as minorities. They wanted to make sure everyone has an equal opportunity to play the sport at the NHL. They don't single out certain people because of your race or your sex. It also connects to functionalist theory because the NHL, hockey in general, is a big organization of interrelated parts. You got your pro leagues, your college leagues, your high school, and your youth level. So it all connects together and everything feeds off each other. And it all starts at the young age and development. Until they are adults. Next up we have the future of the NHL with Richard Conrad.
Alright, all the facts and information that I got is from Steve Thompson, which is analyst for the Bleacher Report. And the last time NHL expanded is 2000, when they made to 30 teams. Now, they're guessing around 2017, they're going to expand to 4 teams, with adding Las Vegas, Seattle, a second Toronto franchise, and Quebec City, which is and by 2017, which is the 100th anniversary of the league. And they're guessing in 2018, in 19 season, NHL would expand again. We'll add Baltimore and Houston. In 2000, In 2001 season, NHL will expand again to add Milwaukee and a second Montreal franchise. And 2023 and 2024 season, to round out the NHL to the next number of 40 teams, the league will expand and will add Spokane and London. And that is it.